Sairam students, welcome to the VE session. Today we are going to start with chapter 7, Rampal's Patience and Gratitude. So gratitude means, children, a thanksgiving, right? So there was a Rampal, a child, was looking at the troubled face of his father. The father's terrified face reflected the fearful scenes he had just witnessed during the partition of India and Pakistan. His father, Devi Prasad, said, "Son, your mother and me are leaving for Delhi now by foot, but we are not sure that we may reach there. The way is fraught with all sorts of evils. So I am sending you along with some soldiers who are leaving by a special train. A friendly soldier has consented to take you to Delhi. You will be safe with them." So what's given in this paragraph, children? There was a child by name Rampal, right? So he saw worries on his father's face, because his father had was just he had gone through the partition of India and Pakistan, and there were a lot of fights and all those things, right? So he saw his father was very worried. So the child's father's name was Devi Prasad, and what did he say? He said, his son, that he and his mother, that means Devi Prasad, his father and his mother, they are going to go to Delhi, but they will be walking to Delhi, right? And they are not sure whether they will reach by foot to Delhi, because on the way there will be a lot of dangers, right? So he said that he is sending his son with some soldiers. And these soldiers, they are going to travel by a special train. And then the soldier has told that he is ready to take his son to Delhi. So he said, if you go along with the soldiers, you will be safe. "May God, Goddess Vaishnavi, protect you. Take this picture of the goddess with you and pray to her whenever you feel like." Devi Prasad then handed over the picture to Rampal and also gave the addresses of his brother Sitaram and his good friend Mahendra Lal, who were in Delhi at that time. That was the last time Rampal saw his parents. So after saying this, that you are going to go with the soldiers, what he said, he gave Devi Prasad, he gave his son the photo of goddess Vaishnavi, and he told, whenever you feel like you have to pray to God, you are feeling worried, that time you can pray to goddess Vaishnavi, right? And then he gave the picture of goddess Vaishnavi, and he also gave the address of his brother Sitaram and his friend Mahendra Lal, who were staying in Delhi. So this was the last time when Rampal, he saw his parents. The soldier left Rampal in a refugee camp in Delhi. The boy stayed there for 6 months. His efforts to contact his uncle and father's friend went in vain, as he received help from nobody in tracing them. So what did the soldiers do? They in a refugee camp, they left him, right? And then there he stayed for 6 months. And then from there, he was trying to contact his uncle and the father's friend Mahendra Lal. But he was not able to contact them. Skin troubles, cold, fever, stomach, ailments and other diseases were endemic in the camp. People were served some roti and dal twice a day. They led a miserable life. Noisy quarrels and tussles were witnessed every now and then. The boy wandered round the camp helplessly, with only the goddess photo in one hand and the address of his uncles in the other. Rampal was sometimes deprived of even 2 square meals. So, since it was a refugee camp, now refugee camp means, children, a temporary facility is given for providing protection for those who have not got home, right? So, there in this camp, there were some type of diseases like skin trouble, then cold, fever, some stomach related problems, and various other diseases. Basically, there was an outbreak of the disease in that particular camp. And there the people were given every day rice and roti and dal, right? Two times a day they used to give this. And the life was not quite good over there, right? The life was very uncomfortable. And every day there used to be quarrels over there. They used to fight. People used to fight over there. Sometimes the fight was physical also. And what this Rampal did, he used to roam around the camp with the photo of the goddess Vaishnavi, right? And then in one hand, the photo of the goddess was there, and in the other hand, his uncle's address was there. And sometimes what used to happen in that camp, sometimes he used to not even get meals also. Though things did get better, a kind officer found Rampal loitering in the camp and asked him about who he was. Rampal recounted everything in detail. The officer traced Sitaram, Rampal's uncle, who gladly took Rampal to his house as he had no son and was getting old himself. So, as days passed by, what happened? There was an officer over there and he used to see every day Rampal wandering here and there. So, one day he asked him about how he is over here. Then Rampal told him the whole situation, what had happened. And then this officer, he helped him in finding out Rampal's uncle, that is Sitaram. And then what he did, he took Rampal to that Sitaram's house. And the Sitaram, who was his uncle, he was having no kids, right? Means, so he was not having son, and also he was growing old. Rampal, now in his new home, served his uncle well. His religious upbringing helped him immensely. Every morning, he used to pray for the welfare of the people of the household. So, now Rampal got a new house and he used to look after his uncle also very well. And as his parents had given him good habits that helped him in serving his uncle. So every morning he used to pray for his uncle and for the people who were living in that house. But ill luck had its own way. Sitaram's wife Nandini did not have a kind heart for Rampal. She thrust various menial jobs on him. Sometimes she became unnecessarily furious and beat him. He was not given even proper meals. So what happened? Sitaram's wife, whose name was Nandini, she was not very good at heart. What she used to do? She used to dump the servant type of jobs on Rampal. And sometimes she used to get angry for unnecessary reasons. And she used to beat him also. And also she used to not give him meals also. He was given a little of the leftover of the day. So he remained mostly hungry. This told upon his health. But Rampal did not lose his patience. He prayed constantly to Goddess Vaishnavi to bless his uncle's family with peace. So what this Sitaram's wife used to do, Nandini, whatever meal was left over, right? Whatever meal is cooked in the day, and it used to remain that she used to give him the next day. So because of this, what used to happen? Rampal used to be hungry most of the time. And then eating the leftover food also, his health was not keeping proper, right? So, but still Rampal, he had not lost his patience. He used to every day pray to Goddess Vaishnavi so that Goddess can bless his family, right? One day Sitaram returned from work to find hell let loose at home. Nandini was screaming at Rampal. She was angry because the boy was not working his best that day. Actually, Rampal was ill. So what happened? One day when Sitaram, after working, he came home. what did he see the condition in the house? He saw that his wife was screaming at Rampal. And why she was screaming? Because she was angry. Because Rampal was not working the way she wanted him to work. Right? And what was the reason Rampal was not able to do? Because Rampal was ill. So he was not able to do the work what Nandini was telling. Sitaram knew what was happening, but had been quiet all the while as he thought that Nandini would develop compassion towards the boy gradually. Presently, Nandini was fuming as she said, "This mean fellow, he eats like an elephant and doesn't want to work. I am fed up of him. Show him the door. I cannot stand him anymore." So, Sitaram used to know what was happening every day in the house, but he used to keep quiet. So he used to think that his wife will understand Rampal and she will try to be good with the boy. But that day when he returned home, he saw that she was very, very angry. And then she started telling that Rampal, he eats like an elephant and still he doesn't do any work. So she is fed up of him. So she was telling Sitaram to remove him from the house. Sitaram calmly said, "He shall go nowhere. He is my brother's son and so as good as my own. I know very well who is mean and who is not." So Sitaram, he said, "Rampal is not going to go anywhere and he is my brother's son. So, and also my son. So he is not going to go anywhere and I know who is mean and who is not." Nandini retorted, Oh, you are taking his side. This brat, he has spoiled my life. He prays for my destruction. Evil boy, evil, he is a devil. Send him out immediately or else I shall leave." Sitaram asked, "Where should I send him? Who is there?" So Nandini, she quickly replied, to Sitaram, that you are taking the boy's side. This brat, now brat means, children, it is a not exactly a bad word, but in Nandini's sense, Rampal was a badly behaved child, so she used this word. So what she told, that he has spoiled my life and every day he's praying to the God that for my destruction. And so she said, "You send him out immediately. Otherwise, I will leave the house." Then what Sitaram said, "Where should I send him?" Then she says, "Send him to Mahendra Lal, my brother. There is nobody to look after him. He is your great pal too. He will look after you, your Rampal well," said Nandini. Sitaram retorted, "I will not send him anywhere." So Nandini said, "You send him to Mahendra Lal." Now Mahendra Lal was Nandini's brother, right? And he was a good friend of Sitaram also. So what Nandini said, "You send Rampal over there because there is nobody to take care of Mahendra Lal." So, and Rampal, so then what Sitaram said, "But I am not going to send Rampal anywhere." All the while, as Sitaram tried to put some sense into his wife, Rampal sat in a corner and prayed. So all this situation was happening. Sitaram was trying to convince his wife, but she was not ready to listen. Whatever these things were happening, Rampal was sat in a corner and he was still praying to God. Sitaram thought, "There is no peace here. The boy will be ruined if he continues to live here." Sitaram decided to take Rampal to Mahendra Lal. Mahendra Lal was not only Nandini's brother but also a childhood friend of Sitaram and Rampal's father, Devi Prasad. He was glad to see Rampal as he reminded him of Devi Prasad. Also, Mahendra Lal was becoming aged and so was looking for someone who could look after him. Having seen Rampal into his new place, Sitaram left. Then what Sitaram thought, that if he stays in his house, he'll not be able to lead a good life because of his wife. So he decided that he will take Rampal to Mahendra Lal. And Mahendra Lal, he was not only Nandini's brother, but he was also a good friend of Sitaram and Devi Prasad, that is Rampal's father, their childhood friend. So when Mahendra Lal saw Rampal, he became happy, right? Because he was growing old and nobody was there to look after him. Then Rampal was Sitaram left from that place. Rampal worked hard, prayed for the welfare of all daily. Mahendra Lal's wife Prema Devi gave him enough food but also gave him much work to do. So Rampal used to work very hard in that house also, and every day as usual he used to pray to God also so that this family could live happily. So Mahendra Lal's wife name was Prema Devi. She used to give enough amount of food to Rampal, but in the same way she used to give him lot of work also. Looking after Mahendra Lal too was a tough task. He grumbled often about service, food, clothing, bed, etc. Rampal maintained utmost patience and tolerance. Prayer helped him and gave him immense mental and physical strength. So since Mahendra Lal was old and Rampal had to look after him, he had to do the Mahendra Lal's wife's work also, right? So it was a tough task for Rampal, right? And Mahendra Lal also sometimes he used to grumble. Now grumble means children, he used to complain about whatever service was being provided to him, about the food, about the clothes, about the bed. But still Rampal, what he did, he used to keep quiet, right? And he used to pray to God. One day a sannyasi came to Mahendra Lal's house. After prayer and satsang, he sat leisurely and asked about the wishes of the family members. Mahendra Lal asked for a long, healthy and prosperous life. His wife wished for a happy married life. His children asked for prosperity, power, health, good future, happiness, etc. So what happened? One day a sannyasi came to Mahendra Lal's house. Then prayers were there, satsang was there, and after that he had some time. So he asked Mahendra Lal's family what do they wish for. Then Mahendra Lal, he asked for a good life, right? Healthy and prosperous life. That is, health will remain good and he will be successful in life. Then his wife, Prema Devi, she said that she wants a good married life. And his children also were there. They asked for a successful life, then power in their hands. Also, they should have a good health, good future and happiness in their life. Even as all sat with folded hands in front of the Swamiji, Rampal was sitting in a corner praying happily. You also asked for something, Prema Devi told Rampal. So everybody were worshipping the Swamiji with their folded hands, whereas Rampal, he was sitting in a corner and again he was praying to his goddess. So what Prema Devi told Rampal, you also asked this sannyasi for something. Reluctantly, he came near the Swamiji, touched his feet and said, my Lord, please grant a long, healthy life to my master, Mr. Mahendra Lal. Without him, I would not have had a home where I got everything. This is my prayer. So what he told Swamiji, that my Lord, my master, Mr. Mahendra Lal, you bless him with a good and healthy life so that he can remain good, in a good condition, right? So if Mahendra Lal was not there, then I would not have got a house to stay in. So just this is my prayer. The Swamiji said, if that is granted, you will be out of the house. You will not be needed here anymore. Rampal said, I am growing. Now I can work. God has given me a healthy body. I can work with my hand and survive. May my master and his family be happy. Please grant this prayer. This alone is my wish. Then what the Swamiji told, that if I grant this wish, what will happen? Now your master Mahendra Lal, he will have a good health. And then you will not be required then to take care of him. So you will be homeless. So why do you want this wish? He tells Rampal. But then what reply Rampal gives? That now I have become I have grown up, right? I can do my work myself. I have got a healthy body. So I have got hands to work. So I can survive by working anywhere. So my wish is only my master's family should be happy. So please fulfill this wish, he says. Mahendralal's eyes become moist. He got up and embraced Rampal. You two are my son, he said. So after hearing this, Mahendralal's eyes, it becomes wet. And then he embraced Rampal, means he took in his arms. And then he tells that Rampal, that you are also my son. Mahendralal then had Rampal receive good education from reputed institutions. The industrious boy Rampal worked hard, acquired merits, and landed in a lucrative job. He continued living happily with Mahendralal's family like Mahendralal's other children. He remained ever grateful to Sitarams and Mahendralal's family for the help and support he received from them during his turbulent childhood. So after this, what happened? Mahendralal, he gave good education to Rampal from a good institution, right? From a branded institution. And Rampal also, he worked very hard. He got himself educated, and then he got a good job also, wherein he got lots of money. And then he stayed happily with Mahendralal's family only, like Mahendralal's son, right? And he was also grateful to Sitaram and Mahendralal's family because they supported him. They helped him in his bad time, right? So whatever he faced, problems he faced during his childhood, so both these families, they helped and supported him, right? So moral of the story is gratitude is the greatest virtue one should possess, right? So we should be thankful to whatever we are getting in our life, right? And we should also be patient because things will work out slowly. We should not get aggressive that why things are not happening, right? So remember, caution and worry never got anything done. Prayers work miracles, right? So this was written by Swami Omkarananda. And what is the maxim? Patience is the ornament of knowledge, right? You have to be very patient in each and everything. Things will work out. And every day you have to pray also. And sometimes miracles can also happen. So this was what in today's session, children. In the next session, we'll start with a new chapter. Till then, goodbye.